I saw the best minds of my generation. Soared by madness, stars never naked. I saw the best minds of my generation. Soared by madness, stars never naked. I saw the best minds of my generation. Soared by madness, stars never naked. I saw the best minds of my generation. Dragging himself as a little dawn, looking for an epic. Best minds of my generation. Angel headed hips are burning for the ancient coming next to the star dynamo in the scenery of night. Who Apollo died in high set of poker in the supernatural darkness of the cold water platform. Such a cup of tears, contemplating jazz.
Best minds of my generation.
Shed their brains to heaven under the yelling storm. Muhammad and angels second through seven to illuminate it.
That kind of God, because he's been accustomed to picking up guitar players, but I don't think he picked up anybody that put a vocal harmony on what he was doing. He got very excited. And about a week later, I found myself in a recording studio at Columbia Records with John Hammond. I didn't know much when I was 20 years old, but I knew who John Hammond was. That was pretty amazing. Everything really changed after that. So I came to the city. It's a long story, but one of the first things that we played together was a song of Alan Settings of the Songs of Innocence and Experience of William Blake. William Blake published the Songs of Innocence in 1789 and the Songs of Experience in 1794, combining them into a book called The Songs of Innocence and of Experience, Showing the Contrary States of the Human Soul. So I'm going to sing a couple of tunes from Innocence, as said by Alan. In 1968, after the Democratic Convention, Ginsberg was taking a bus back east, and he said that he had been horrified by the revelation of the bare skull of state violence that he had witnessed, and he heard a little voice in his ear singing. He was given to auditory hallucinations, particularly coming from William Blake, but he heard a little voice singing, "Vain the sword, vain the bow, they never shall wars for overthrow." And he went back to his farm in Cherry Valley and sat at the harmonium and stayed up two nights setting the Songs of Innocence and Experience to music. And I've been now doing this. I told Alan, when Alan was dying, he did a very Ginsbergian thing. He phoned everybody. He phoned all his friends and family to say that he was dying. And he said, "They tell me I have about 3 months, but I feel like it's about 3 weeks," and he was right. And he said, "Finish the Blake, finish the Blake." I had been talking about doing his Blake songs for so long, and so now 20 years after the fact, I'm finally getting around to doing something with these Blake songs. So, something like this. This is the introduction to Innocence, followed by The Shepherd.
Piping down the valley's water, piping songs unpleasantly. On a cloud I saw a child, and he laughing said to me, "Pipe song about land." So I piped with merry cheer, "Pipe, oh, pipe that song again." So I piped, he wept to hear, "To run, run, pipe thy happy pipe. Sing thy songs of happy cheer." So I sung the same again, while he wept with joy to hear. Then sit he down and write in a book that all may be. So he vanished from my sight, and I plucked a hollow reed, and I made a roll of pen, and I stained the water clear, and I wrote my happy songs every child may joy to hear.
Tender reply.
eyes, in happy disguise, the nebula's dream to welcome the spring, the skylark and rush, the birds of the bush sing louder around to the bear's gentle sound. Sitting under the oak, among the old folk, they laugh at our play, and soon they all say, such were the joys, when we all girls and boys, in our new time, were singing on the echoing dreams. Till the little ones weep, no more can be merry, the sun does descend, and our sports have an end. Round the laps of their mothers, many sisters and brothers, like birds in their nest, are ready for rest. Export no more seen on the darkening green.
Innocence and experience, the two contrary states of the human soul, he's regarded as a playful regarded as a romantic. It's a very romantic notion of the unspoiled purity of the child and the wizened cynicism of the elder, and how you have to bring the two spirits. Those two spirits have to mature together. The blossom.
Mary sparrow, under leaf so green. Sees you swift as arrow, seek your cradle narrow, near my bosom, pretty, pretty robin, underneath so green. A happy blossom, hears you sobbing, sobbing, pretty, pretty robin, near my bosom.
These poems, thank you. These songs of experience come down to us as poems on the page, but we know from diarist, memoirist who knew Blake that he sang his songs of innocence, and he sang his songs at the salon of a Mrs. Matthew, a famous bluestocking of the period in London, who had a salon. Blake was a favorite guest for a number of years, and he sang his songs, and it is noted in his autobiographies that and in the diaries of those present that he had a nice voice, and that some of the tunes were quite memorable and good, and that musician professors who were present at the time wrote them down. Those notes are lost. But I often think, you know, if you found out who was on Mrs. Matthews' guest list, and you tracked down those musician professors and their family archives or papers, you might find those scribblings and rediscover the tunes of William Blake. The chimney sweeper. Blake was a kind of prophet of the horrors of the Industrial Revolution that was really just getting done when he was in London. But at the time, children were sold into labor. Poor children and orphans were sold into labor, and very small boys, were sold to chimney sweeps, where they were required to crawl up the chimney naked. To clear out the chimneys. They crawl up the chimneys naked in order to avoid soiling their clothes so that their overseers would not have to spend money replacing or repairing or cleaning clothes. So naked little boys crawled up your chimney, and there was a great deal of illness and terrible accidents and a lot of death. There was apparently a lot of cancer with the scrotum among these boys. The carcinogens of the tar, the coal fires in London, apparently infected those plants, and there was a lot of death from that. So I'm going to try to do this. This is the chimney sweeper from Innocence. And then I will read the chimney sweeper from Experience.
When my mother died, I was very young, and my father sold me, while yet my tongue could scarcely cry. Wee, 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 wee. So your chimneys I sweep, and in soot I sleep. There's the little Tom Dacra who cried when he said, there's little Tom Dacra who cried when his head that curled like a lamb's back was shaved. So I said, hush, Tom, never mind it. For when your head's bare, you know that the soot cannot spoil your white hair. And so he was quiet in that very night. As Tom was asleep, he had such a sight. The thousands of sweepers, Dick, Mo, Ned, and Jack, were all of them locked up in coffins of black. And by came an angel who had a bright key. And he opened the coffins and set them all free. Then down the green plain, leaping, laughing, they run, and wash in a river and shine in the sun. Then naked and white, all their bags left behind, they rise upon clouds and sport in the wind. And the angel told Tom, if he'd be a good boy, he'd have God for his father and never want joy. And so Tom awoke, and we rose in the dark, and got with our bags and our brushes to work. Though the morning was cold, Tom was happy and warm. So if all do their duty, they need not fear harm. That's Innocence. You may be a slave, and you may be abused, and you may be exploited and worked to death and sold as a child of slavery, but if you do your job, you need not fear harm. That's Innocence. Now here's the chimney sweep from Experience. A little black thing on the snow, crying weep, weep, in notes of woe. Where are thy father and mother, say? They are both gone up to the church to pray. Because I was happy upon the heath and smiled among the winter snow, they clothed me in the clothes of death and taught me to sing the notes of woe. And because I am happy and dance and sing, they think they have done me no injury and are gone to praise God and his priest and king who make up a heaven of our misery. That's Experience.
Test. March 13th. This is one of the final poems that Allen Ginsberg wrote. Looking out of his hospital window on March 23rd. It's called Starry Rhymes. March 15th, Gary Snyder called Ginsberg. Bob Rosenthal answered. We told him the diabetes, the heart murmur, and various medications had joined to make the bard very disoriented and fatigued. Snyder called AG in the hospital, who told his old pal he'd been diagnosed with a recurrence of hepatitis C. He was so medicated he wasn't able to talk very clearly, Snyder later wrote. When Alan was brought to Beth Israel, an emergency room doctor handed him a poem asking for suggestions. And the frail poet complied on the spot, made some notes, and the bard, who wrote in sapphic stanzas, thought he improved some of the lines of the devotee of Asclepius. Then at 4:51 in the morning of March 23rd, he was looking out of his hospital window and wrote the beautiful four quatrain Starry Rhymes. Just before he passed away, Alan called my
my house in Woodstock and to say goodbye. And he remembered our daughter, whom he hadn't seen in a long time, and he expressed his best wishes for her. He was one of my heroes when the river of freedom flows and the blossom of of naked truth above the burning fields of the earth. Ah, Alan, your sky rocket mind up there with Sappho and Keats, exploding with such a wide, wild corona out over our little part of the Milky Way. He was one of my
to decipher the glyphs,
No time to sort the papers. No time to measure the moonlight. No time to grow the peppers. No time to argue for freedom. No time to dismantle the fear. No time to savor the visions. No time, no time, no time, no time. He was one of my heroes. Where the river of free down flows, and the blossom of pink spirits of eternity to raise the White House from its foundations, spin it around, and cleanse it of evil and malevolent demons. Out, Trump cabinet, out, out, Trump demons, out, Attorney General, aye, demon out, CIA director, aye, out, demons out, head of the EPA, aye, demon out, Secretary of Agriculture, aye, demon out, demon out. Health and Human Services, aye, out, demons out.